Hello students, welcome back to my channel. In this video, we will talk about the circular flow of income in a four-sector model. The circular flow of income in a four-sector economy is a model that will show how money would flow between the four sectors of the economy. So, given the names of the four sectors, we have households, firms, the government, and the foreign sector or the external sector. Now, this model will show how these four sectors interact with each other to produce and consume goods and services. So, without wasting any time further, let's take a look at how income would flow in a four-sector model. So, the circular flow of income will show how these four sectors are interconnected, and each sector's income is derived from other sectors, and each sector's spending would contribute to the income generation of other sectors. Households spend money on goods and services produced by the businesses, which generates income for businesses. Businesses, on the other hand, would use this income to pay for the resources that they purchase from households, and it will also invest in new production techniques or technologies. The government would also spend money on goods and services that are produced by the businesses, which will also be an income flow for the businesses. The fourth sector here is called as the external sector, which is getting introduced in this particular model. This sector is also referred to as the rest of the world. So when we talk about households, households would interact with the foreign sector by exporting and importing goods and services. Say for example, a household might export labor services to a foreign firm by working remotely or by providing consulting services. The household might also import goods and services from foreign sectors, such as purchasing clothing, electronics, food items, so on and so forth. When we talk about firms, the firms would interact by the foreign sector again by exporting or importing goods and services. In this case, the exporting and importing would be a little different than the households. Say for example, a firm might import raw materials, machines, components, and export its products to foreign customers or businesses. When we talk about government, the government would interact with the foreign sector in multiple ways, such as taking decisions with regards to trade policies, foreign aid, international agreements, so on and so forth. So after you finish the video, try answering this question. In the circular flow, households and businesses aren't just interacting locally. They are also dealing with the foreign sector. So how might international agreements impact the way businesses operate or the choices that households make? Hey students, if you learn from my videos, please do not forget to like and subscribe to my channel. Also, do share my videos with your classmates and friends if you think they could too learn from these videos. Yeah? All right, let's take a look at the explanation and diagrammatic representation of the four-sector model. So this is how the circular flow of income in a four-sector model would be depicted. So we have four sectors here: households, firms, government, and the rest of the world. There are individual videos on my channel with regards to circular flow of income in two-sector model, in three-sector model, and this is the four-sector model. When we talk about four-sector model, the households and firms would be dealing with the rest of the world. The blue and the purple flows here are basically the nominal flows or money flows. I haven't included the real flow here because the diagram would look too clumsy like this. So it is assumed that for each money flow, there's a real flow which moves in the opposite direction. I will put it in the explanation, try and figure that out. Okay. So when we talk about households, we see that there is a payment for imports that the households are making to the rest of the world. So this is the monetary flow that is happening from households to the rest of the world. So the opposite flow would be the real flow that households are making, that would go from the rest of the world to the households in terms of the imports that the households are making. The same is applicable for the firms, where they are making payments for the imports that they are making with the rest of the world in the form of raw materials, equipment, technical know-how. All right. Another flow that we see emanating from the rest of the world is foreign remittances that the households are getting. Basically, what this means is that households are supplying labor services to the rest of the world, and when those people who are working abroad, they send money back home, that is called as foreign remittances. So that is the flow that is beginning from the rest of the world and it goes all the way to the households. When we talk about firms, they are exporting to the rest of the world. That means they are selling goods and services to the rest of the world or foreign countries or businesses, and they get paid for the same. So that's the purple flow here, which is written as receipts from the exports. So again, it's a nominal flow that is recorded here. The real flow would be obviously movement of labor in this case, and in this case it could be movement of goods and services, both. So that's how the rest of the world would interact with households and the firms. So let us quickly see how the equilibrium scenario is depicted in a four sector model. So this is how the equilibrium scenario is depicted in a four sector model. The first approach that we are taking a look at is aggregate demand, aggregate supply approach. Now, this is the four sector model. We have all the four sectors here. So all the four components of aggregate demand would be included here, which is consumption expenditure, investment expenditure, government expenditure, and net exports. We know by now that aggregate supply is equal to income, since at the point of equilibrium, AD should be equal to AS, or aggregate demand should be equal to aggregate supply. This is how we get the equation for equilibrium under the AD-AS approach. The second approach that we can take is injections or leakages approach. So in the four sector model, imports are leakages, exports are injections. We should know by now what do we mean by leakages and what do we mean by injections. So at the point of equilibrium, total injections should be equal to the total leakages in the economy. So we put all the injections on one side, which is I plus G plus X. X stands for exports, and leakages on the other, which is S plus T plus M. S stands for savings, T is taxes, M is imports. For I, we have investments, G is government spending. So this is how the equilibrium scenario would be depicted under the injections and leakages approach. If there is a disequilibrium in the economy, you would see either of these two scenarios prevailing in the economy. So the first scenario is where I plus G plus X is greater than S plus T plus M. So we know that injections are greater than leakages. So that would expand the circular flow because there's more money injected into the economy. And if this is the scenario where I plus G plus X is smaller than S plus T plus M, we know that injections are smaller than leakages, more money is getting leaked out. So that would contract the circular flow of income. So this is how the four sector model would be depicted, and this is how it should be concluded. Do not forget to work on the question that I had mentioned in the video. If you don't remember the question, please go back and see what the question is and try and attempt that question, because that will help you to understand if you are able to follow how the injections and leakages work and are impacted by the decisions that governments may take with regards to its trade policies. So I will see you in another video with a different topic. All right, students, take care. Bye now.